All right, y'all, this is Claude. He is a standard poodle. He's 10. And he's just the sweetest thing ever. I love him to bits. He comes in about every 2 months, 2-3 months. And he just gets shaved down really short. They cut him down real short. He gets a number 10. The only thing that we leave on him is his mohawk. Everything else comes off. Come here. Put that around your neck. He's so good for an old dog. That's really good. He still hops onto the table, hops into the tub. Normally he's one of the first few in the morning that I've finished. But today it's been, I've had a really full book today. I've had a total of 12 dogs today. So I let him, I bathed him, grew him, and then I just let him go out and play because he's here for daycare too. So gives him time to go out and play and get off some of the energy. He's usually good for his German animal, like he's not very good. I did do a time lapse of him, I think sometime last year. I believe it's on my Facebook page, so if you want to see that, you can go over there and see it. Can you hear something?
I on my shoulder.
What are you doing? Are you like sitting? He's like sitting on my shoulder. He's sitting on my shoulder. What are you doing? Oh my goodness. You're so silly, Claude. He's literally sitting on my shoulder, girl.
Dr. Moses, call
1-800.
Dr. Moses,
1-800. You know, this is not the first time he's done that either. I guess it's easier. His light's up a little high, so. I always hate shaving, doing clean feet on this side. It's always difficult for me. Doesn't matter what dog it is. I think it's because I'm more right-handed. So if I had something on this side instead of this side, it's a lot easier. Me. finish this leg and then I'll let you sit down. Okay? Finish this foot. Slip her blade. I want a warm blade in your foot. Especially around the holiday season.
Cool it down, we're cooling in a van.
fuck today, buddy. And I know you're not gonna like it. I'm very sorry. But they're trying to get a little bushy in there. Yeah, that's the only time I really pluck your ears. Yeah, the only time I pluck ears is if an owner requests it, or if I see that they're really, really hairy, or they're starting to get infected. My reasoning behind that is because I've noticed that over-plucking and just constantly plucking, it just causes irritation to the dog's ear. And sometimes that can damage the inside of the ear and cause infections because the area is infected and then you have all the bacteria flowing in there. You're supposed to have some hair in there to protect the ear from any, you know, bacteria like that. That's the whole purpose of the ear hair. But not all trimmers are like that. All of some trimmers, you know, they don't pluck at all. Some pluck every time. I'm not one of those trimmers. It will not pluck every time. Because it hurts, it doesn't feel good. So I try to do it every other time when he comes in. Last time they were not that bad. I mean, they're really not that bad now, but I'm gonna pluck them just because they're starting to get to that point to where if I leave them now, they'll get really bad and then they'll get an infection and I'm trying to avoid that. These ear infections are real fun. I think you can all just try that. Stretch. Always stretch. And there's my little pocket right there. And that sucker sometimes can get in the between. And always make sure you're holding your mouth a little bit firm so they don't stick your tongue out. You don't want to have a night at Harry's prominent. His tongues, unfortunately, when they get cut, there's nothing you can do for it. It just has to, you know, bleed out. Normally, you just put the dog back up if something were to happen like that, and as soon as they calm down, the bleeding stops. But when they're stressed out and stuff like that, stuff's going on, it's going to keep bleeding. so stiff from today. I'm gonna go home and edit these videos and end up turning into a freaking potato. Oh!
Yeah, I want to talk to your girl. You know what sounds good to me, Carl? A big fat Whopper. Not that I need it, but it's quick and easy. I just eat it without the bun. I go acne style. You know, I always wonder, speaking of junk food, fast food, why is that shit always so damn cheap, but, like, the healthy food is so expensive. Like, I know it's, you know, the farmers and stuff like that, they put a lot of hard work into it, and it's probably part of it. But, I mean, like, they have their cows and stuff, and burgers don't cost that much. So why is that a damn carrot? Or a tomato? So much more money. Or even salmon. Fish. Whew. I love me some salmon though, y'all. Put some honey. A little soy sauce. A little ginger, lemon. Sesame seeds on that sucker. Got yourself a good piece of meat. Yeah, so a piece of fish.
To me.
So a few wispies out to get on your lips. So we're gonna take some length off of it. With a little scissor. I know with a scissor. So we're just gonna get another 9. Scissor his, but I'm really pooped. So I'm kind of half out, to be quite honest. I do need to go over your private a little bit better. Got some spots in there I gotta get. I'm gonna use my Sebastian for this. Go from the corner of the eye, so I'm going to scissor all of this out. I can see the line starts there from where I shaved. And the reason why I was taking length off of his top knot is because, or his mohawk rather, is because it does tend to mat up. Ever since I started doing this to my poodle, it does the same thing. So his collar actually kept getting into the way, so he just has a mohawk up there. But he did have it just like Claude's.
He was the inspiration.
Just follow that line all the way down. Brush it down to the sides. You can see I still have hair there, and I have a hair. Wait, no, you can't see. I have hairs on this side that I have to trim up still. This. Chiatis that are out over here. We're gonna blend it to where it kind of, and just kind of blend it in so that the sides are not so harsh. I'm telling y'all, if y'all don't have a pair of chunkers, you need to get you a pair. And if you want a really good cheap pair, you don't want to join the Foxy Roxy Club, Scissor Club, and wait for one or order one, you can go to Amazon. I'll put the link down below. These ones, I think they're like $22. I got those off of Amazon. I use those ones a lot too. I used to use those ones a lot more than I use these Sebastians, but ever since I got these Sebastian ones, they are all I use, just about. I mean, I still use those ones that I just showed y'all, but I really, really, really love these Sebastian ones by Gip. Thing I love about these Barberas, you go from a 9 to a 40 in seconds. Really good to go over dogs when you're done-ish. I've had these clippers for, God, I don't even know. And I've dropped these things so many times, I'm telling y'all. Y'all are looking for a clipper, you need to get a clipper by the wall. That's my preference. Though, Andis does have some pretty good ones. I do like their two-speed. I think they're blue or pink. I like those ones. And then the old-fashioned ones that they have that are like brown. All right, Bubby. Squirt you up.
Some conditioner.
Give you some whippy scents. Make you smell like a man. Y'all don't know the man spray. That's the man spray. And he's done. See you next time. Oh, look at my hair, y'all. It's going all crazy right there.
That's what happens at the end of the day when you be doing so many dogs. You look a hot mess. I need to go home and groom myself. Bye, y'all.